It's common as you grow with Final Cut Pro to want to customize the built-in titles beyond what is available. To accomplish this, many Final Cut editors turn to motion. From the Titles and Generators sidebar, right-click on the title to be customized and select Open a Copy in Motion. Apple describes Motion as a behavior-driven motion graphics application. This advanced application has a relatively clean interface with four main areas below the toolbar. The library and inspector displayed in the left column with the canvas on the right and the project pane in the middle. Similar to Final Cut's timeline, the timing pane is at the bottom. Drag the playhead to skim about 10 seconds in when all the text is visible on the canvas. Before making changes, use the project pane to understand the different layers. This keynote template has two groups, one for the background and a second that contains the primary layers of this composition, including the drop zone and text. Click on the white layer and notice the outline of the layer is displayed in the canvas. Use the checkbox to the left of the layer to show or hide it. In this case, the white layer is creating the reflection of the drop zone above it. Activate the HUD from the toolbar. The HUD displays common controls for the selected layer. By lowering the opacity, the reflection is less noticeable. Additional controls are available from the inspector. The drop zone has a small black border around the edge created using the simple border filter. For this project, we want the border to be purple. Select the title source drop zone. Then, in the inspector, under filters, change the color. This template has many different objects, and most of them are animated. The border starts off small and becomes larger when the drop zone rotates. This animation was accomplished by adding keyframes to the width parameter. Knowing how to add and adjust keyframes is a skill that takes time to understand. It's easy to avoid messing with objects that already have keyframes by looking for the visual cues. Notice the width of 10 is red. Red text indicates this parameter has keyframes. If an adjustment is made to a parameter when it is red, an additional keyframe is added or changed. Because of this, you should avoid making changes to this parameter to prevent unintended animation. The next group in this composition includes all of the text. Click the triangles to see the additional layers. Remove one of the bullet points by selecting the layer and pressing the delete key on the keyboard. Or add an additional point by selecting the layer and duplicating it. Select the new layer, then drag it down in the canvas. The yellow alignment guides help keep the elements aligned correctly. Once the template is customized the way you want it, save the project and return to Final Cut. The original template is unchanged, but a copy with the changes is now ready to use. In addition to customizing the titles built into Final Cut, use Motion to create and add additional titles to Final Cut. Start by opening Motion and selecting Final Cut Title from the project browser. To the right, select the desired preset, frame rate, and duration, then click Open. Those settings can be adjusted by first clicking Project under the Layers tab of the Project pane or from the Timing pane. Then, locate the Properties Inspector to make adjustments. With the project created, click the T to enable the Text tool. Then, click anywhere on the canvas to add the first layer of text. The Text tool can also be enabled by pressing the T key on the keyboard. Pressing T a second time allows you to type 3D text using the Text tool. Use the HUD and the text inspector to customize the format, appearance, and layout of the text as desired. Additional customizations can be accomplished using filters. With a layer of text selected, use the toolbar to add the glow filter. Filters can also be added to a group. Select the group that contains both layers of text and add the Gaussian blur. Increase the amount of the blur. Filters, like most attributes in motion, can be animated over time with keyframes. Press the Add Keyframe button next to the amount under the Gaussian blur. With the playhead set at the beginning of the project, the Gaussian blur is going to be set at the current amount. Move the playhead to the 2-second mark. Lower the blur amount to 0. Notice a keyframe is automatically added. Press the spacebar to play your project and notice how the text becomes in focus over the first 2 seconds. If your computer is not able to play the results in real time, press Command-R to render a RAM preview of the play range. This is a simple example of how to add and customize a filter. Spend some time learning how each filter works by adding them to some text, and use the inspector to make adjustments. Animating text can be accomplished in the Properties Inspector by adding keyframes to the position, rotation, and other attributes. But in most cases, you'll find behaviors is much quicker. Say we want the top layer of text to slide in. With the layer of text selected, click Behaviors, Text Basic, Slide In. Play the project and notice how each letter slides onto the screen. It's a little busy. Use the inspector or HUD to change the animate attribute to word. Now the entire word slides in at once. To make that type of change with keyframes would take significantly more time. At the end of our title, all of the text will fade away. With the group selected, add the fade in, fade out behavior located in the basic motion group. Use the HUD to eliminate the fade-in by dragging the fade-in to 0 frames. The Share menu can be used to export the final project. However, because we chose Final Cut Title, by saving the project, it is automatically a template available within Final Cut. Return to Final Cut and perform a search for the new title. Add it to your project and use the inspector to make changes. Now that I'm here, I changed my mind. I'd actually like the slide in to happen by letter and not by word. If there's a customization not available within Final Cut, return to your motion project. Find the control using the inspector. Then click Publish under the drop-down menu. Save the motion project and return to Final Cut. Replace the title and notice we now have a published parameter for the type of animation, and I can change it between character and word at any time without needing to return to motion. Motion is available in the Mac App Store for $49. And is an excellent tool for any Final Cut Pro editor. Want to learn more? Leave a comment or send me an email with your topic requests and questions. And don't forget to have a magnificent day.